In a shock moment for Nevo Mchangwa, High Court Judge Justice Esther Muremba postponed bail ruling on grounds that records into the matter had gone missing or had not been presented to her. Justice Muremba, in postponing the bail ruling to Monday, 27 May, in which Nevo Mchangwa, the son of two top ZANU-PF Politburo member in Chris Mchangwa, spokesperson, and Monica Mchangwa in the Women's League, is fighting for his freedom after 2 weeks in remand prison. Muremba said she was unable to come up with the ruling because she was yet to receive correct records of the proceedings from the lower court, especially the evidence from the investigating officer. Nevo's lawyer, Josephine Sande, explained what had taken place in court as her client now awaits May 27 for determination.
So what transpired in court today is that the ruling for State versus Nevo Mchangwa was scheduled for today. Unfortunately, the Honorable Judge did not deliver a judgment. The reasons was that she didn't see the corrected record of proceedings from Rotten Record. But we insisted as lawyers that we had filed the correct record. It was unfortunate that during that session, we could not prove because we had no access to the ICAMS. So the court then deferred the ruling to Monday next week. So dissatisfied with the proceedings that happened in court, we had to go back into the ICAMS system to check that whether indeed we did not file the correct record. But fortunately, we only discovered that the correct record was in court. We had to seek audience with the judge and then clarify the matter. As we speak now, the matter has been clarified. The record was indeed filed, but unfortunately, the court had already postponed the matter to Monday. The court do not expedite the matter far better than that, and the matter was further delayed to Monday. Yes. So, as much as we clarified our position as lawyers that it was not our fault, we filed the papers accordingly, the record was duly filed, the court had already made its ruling, and it also indicated that it needed time to go through the record as it is in the system, so that maybe on Monday they will give a ruling for the state. So we understand the court's position and respect the court's decision, but however, we also wished for it to have been deferred to an earlier date. But then, it's, what is it? We feel that our clients also supposed to be afforded time. This is an urgent matter which we feel the court must take note of the urgency of the matter in deciding the bail application that is before it. That's all. That's what.
While the son of ZANU-PF spokesperson Christopher Mchangwa was singing the blues as he fights charges of illegal foreign currency dealings, in another case, Justice Muremba granted bail to other accused persons who were arrested and are facing similar charges of reportedly illegally dealing in foreign currency and undermining the new local ZIG currency. Their lawyer, Moses Mapanga, told journalists, Francis Churungu, Chancellor Tendai, and Debate Mahachi were among the alleged 67 money changers were granted bail after the court found they were no compelling reasons why the alleged money dealers were being denied bail.
Money changers, I don't know a bail who are in my state court. What poor bail? Name told me. Main reason I happened to be able to do Panama compelling reasons why you want to challenge very much. Yeah, do in brief and show and do something.
Neville was being forced to spend another long weekend in cold remand prison cells while the lawyers uploaded the important documents. His father and mother, a minister in President Emmerson Dambudzo Mnangagwa's government, were singing and chanting revolutionary songs at the ZANU-PF headquarters, where the War Veterans League was having its first national conference. Reporting from the Harare High Court, Blessed Mhlanga for HSTV.